project. Tell me about it.
Well, my project, I was selected by the British Council in Uganda to be a British Council climate change champion. And they selected me as one of a known personality, because I'm a singer, who is a role model to the youth, and who can reach the youth by spreading the message of climate change in a very, very simple way. So, like, you know, how do you make a very complex subject very simple? For example, like in a 4-minute song that the youth will appreciate and like and understand and learn from. So that was my job.
And do you find it has an effect by singing to the youth, by simplifying the message, that a subject they might not have been interested in before, they're now becoming interested in?
Oh, it has an amazing effect, even on me. When I first learned about the British Council's climate change project, it's such an intense, very, very, you would almost say boring topic. You know, climate change is a very boring topic. So the hardest part for me was, how do you make this exciting to the youth? And by making it so simple to understand and very easy terms, simple things like planting trees, keep your environment clean, the youth listen to that and they understand that. And that's been a very, very easy and effective way for me to communicate. And, you know, music is always a hit with the youth. So it's been doing very well.
And once they understand the problem, do you find they then take up the subject, they become interested, concerned about the issue of climate change?
Yes, they do. The minute they do understand what they're singing about, automatically they start caring about the environment, planting trees, you know, on Facebook. Everyone's like, oh, how can we plant more trees? How can we do something? You know, all of a sudden, because of a song, the youth are very, very excited and they want to know what more they can do to save their environment.
What are the specific, some of the major problems that Uganda faces in relation to climate change?
Well, landslides is one of them. Obviously, we're agricultural-based economy. These days, the extreme changes in temperature, you're expecting the rains at a certain period, and that's exactly when the rains don't come. So there's a lot of famine, poverty going on, floods. When it rains, the roads are clogged. So these are the major problems that Uganda is facing.
And will there be attention focused on Cancun in Uganda? Will people be watching and waiting for some kind of agreement, some kind of accord from the politicians here in Cancun?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Do you think there will be focus, there will be interest, people in Uganda will be following the progress of these negotiations
in
Cancun?
Oh yes, they're very, very, very interested, because they want to know. People are getting very concerned, you know. Unfortunately, a lot think that it's faith-based, the end of the world is coming. So it's our duty to tell them that no, it's not the end of the world. So most of them are beginning to expect, you know, what can we do about this climate change topic. So a lot of them are interested in the COP16 and are tuning in.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah. And if you could now give us a demonstration, that would be fantastic, if you could sing us a song.
Okay. Well, I'll just sing the chorus of the song. Yeah. The name of the song is Let's Go Green. And the simple chorus is, let's go green, keep it clean. So that's pretty much the chorus. Let's go green, keep it clean.
give us a bit more.
Okay. And the verse, seasons have changed, the weather forecast is not the same anymore, oh, causing poverty, famine, disease, and death. Seasons have changed, things don't happen the way that they did before. Now there's floods, landslides, droughts, and many more. Where are we headed for? Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.